is going, guys? Hope you're doing great. So today it's June 8th. It's currently 6:42, and today I'll be pretty much vlogging the entire day, showing you guys what I do on a regular day while prepping. So yeah, it's going to be pretty cool. And right now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna drink some water, get some coffee, do some computer work, and then I'm heading to do cardio, and I'll take you guys along with me. So yeah, let's get it going. Yeah, in the morning I really like to get started, you know, working on my computer, because for those of you who don't know, I do provide online coaching. So I really like to get started with that, because to my clients it's very important that I get in touch with them every single day and make sure that they are on track. But apart to that, I really like to, after this and finishing my coffee, I like to do my cardio in the morning, mainly because I hate doing cardio after working out. Now I'm gonna finish my coffee and I'll catch you guys at cardio. And the kind of cardio I do, I just walk. So yeah, catch you guys there. Give me the ball. Do you want a ball? Give me the ball. Alright guys, so this one right here, Roxy. This one is Roxy. Roxy, hey, come here. She's my little schnauzer, and right now we're about to go for a walk. I usually shoot for about 6,000 to 7,000 steps in my morning walks, mainly because I really like to get more done in the morning. So my goal, my step goal for the day is about 10,000 steps. If I hit 7,000 steps in the morning, the rest of the day just becomes so much easier. Now I'm gonna stop recording because the humidity here is crazy and the lens are starting to mop. I just want to touch up on something that I get asked all the time, and is, you know, why I do, like, I do more walking than, let's say, running or doing like HIIT cardio. For, you know, time management, and because, you know, you do HIIT cardio, you burn more calories in a shorter period of time, and that's true, that's correct. But the thing is, right now, since I'm in a deficit, my goal is to keep as much muscle as possible. In order to do that, I want to recover properly from training session to training session. And the thing is, I train my legs multiple times a week, so like for me doing sprints won't allow me, because I've tried before, when I do sprints, I just don't recover well from training session to training session. So let's say I do legs on Monday, and then I do legs again on Wednesday. If I do a HIIT circuit in between those days, I just won't be able to recover well. And again, I want to keep as much muscle as possible during this cut. That's why I'm doing a slow phase cardio. I just go off these walks, guys. It's just increase my calorie expenditure through the day. That way it's easier for me to stay in a deficit. That's it. All right guys, so I just finished my walk. Pretty good pace, actually. I did about 9,000 steps, almost 10,000. That's great. So, and it's just 9 a.m. in the morning. So now what I'm about to do is I'm gonna take a shower, get the breakfast going, and catch you guys there. About to have my first meal of the day. I love to have oatmeal. So this is a giant bowl of oatmeal. So what it is 160 grams of oatmeal, one scoop of whey protein from One Up Nutrition that I'll show you guys in a bit. I added two servings of peanut butter, and I think that's it, and some zero calorie sweetener. What I do, I mix it up, I leave it like on microwave for about 6 minutes, and then I let it rest, and then I do that like two more times. That's why it gets so thick. If I didn't do it in that way, it will be like super watery, and I don't like it that way. Taste Tess, peanut butter, oatmeal. Nothing beats it. This is a pretty good. If you guys want the recipe, comment below. I might share a recipe later. A few things that I want to tell you guys about my diet right now, since I'm in a fat loss phase. I prefer to have fewer meals, but with higher amounts of food. So that helps me on pretty much keeping myself full and not noticing that I'm dieting. It doesn't matter how many meals you do per day, it's that you get to your calorie goal. So when I'm bulking, I prefer to have like maybe four or five meals. When I'm in a fat loss phase, I prefer to do about 3 to 2 meals. Not usually two, but mostly 3. So I want to go over my current supplementation. So multivitamin, super basic stuff. One pill, one vitamin C supplement, one pill as well. Then I also do vitamin D. And the reason why is because since now we are, you know, getting out of quarantine, most of the time I don't get to spend enough time out, so I don't get enough sunlight. And you get vitamin D mainly for sunlight. That's why I'm supplementing that. And I also take fish oil, one pill. I take whey protein. Pretty much, this is not necessary by any means, but it's pretty good because it helps you on, you know, getting your target protein for the day. This is not my favorite flavor, actually. My favorite one is the blueberry muffin flavor from 1UP. They're pretty good, and I usually add it to my oatmeal, and it tastes amazing. And then I'll use creatine. So creatine, I do about 5 grams per day, every single day. I don't cycle it, I don't get off it. Just take it 5 grams a day and you're good to go. So that's my current supplementation. Basic, I know, it's pretty much what you need. Now I'm gonna pop in these pills. I'm gonna rest for a little bit and then catch you guys at the gym. I'm not afraid to back home. It's currently 8:21 and now I'm about to make my last meal, which is going to be, surprisingly, a giant mountain of protein French toast. So I'll show you guys pretty much what I do. Very simple, just add here, this is the mixture. So here I have 10 servings of egg whites, some cinnamon, just a little bit of almond milk, the 30 calorie option that they have. I mix everything with some artificial sweetener, and then I have my bread of choice. So I do this 40 calorie bread. It's pretty cool because it's 40 calories per slice, and I do about 11 slices. So I'm gonna show you guys how I make it, and then I'm gonna show you the final product. Alright guys, so here in front of me I have the final product. So in total I have 11 pieces of French toast. Let me show you here. And I'm having that with a serving of Greek yogurt. And the syrup that I'm using is this sugar-free syrup. This entire meal comes down to about 1,000 calories, over 60 grams of protein. I have to check again. But yeah guys, I can't get away with eating these big meals because I'm eating about just 3 meals per day. And I'm tracking everything. So also I have to point out that it's very early on my prep. So I'm about almost a little bit less than 5 months away. That means that I am still able to fit this kind of stuff in my diet. The closer I get to the more restrictive my diet will be. But for now I can get away with enjoying this. And now I'm getting shredded, I'm getting leaner eating like this. Guys, this is just too good and super filling for the amount of protein. And hey guys, this is way too good. Yeah, I'm gonna finish this and catch you guys later. Alright guys, check this out. So it did not stand a chance, I can tell you that for sure. Hope you guys liked the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and you know, stay tuned because I'll be thanking you guys along with me in this whole prep, this whole journey. So thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next one.